Hello everyone, I am Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to the series called RBI 247. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try to discuss them with the help of different questions. So for all those who are there for the very first time, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon for all latest updates and notifications. You can also join our Telegram group. In this very group, we share some free quizzes as well as the updates for all our latest videos. So let's get started now. This is the very first question, which says, what does it refer to? So we have two statements over here and we have to identify the concept being talked about. So the first one says, it is a benchmark interest rate at which major global banks lend to one another in the international interbank market for short-term loans. And the second one says that due to the scandals and questions around its validity, as a benchmark rate, it is being phased out. So they are talking about a benchmark interest rate at which your banks lend and borrow from each other for short term. So agar koi bank hai, usko short term ke liye kuch amount dusre bank se borrow karna hai, interbank market se borrow karna hai, to ye ek benchmark rate hai, ek reference rate hai, jo use kiya jata hai decide karne pe ki kitna interest rate pe loan milenge. So, the rate which they are talking about over here is LIBOR, London Interbank Offered Rate. So, this is the rate at which banks agree to borrow and lend from each other in short term. Okay, but because there was a lot of manipulation of this LIBOR in 2012, the LIBOR scandal came out, and because of which its validity is being questioned. And now, not only UK is focusing on phasing it out, but it is used as a benchmark rate in different countries. So all are focusing on phasing it out because of the manipulative practices associated with LIBOR. So we'll be discussing what are the issues with respect to LIBOR, how it is being manipulated, what was the LIBOR scandal, and then why it is being phased out. Okay, so answer to this question is option B, LIBOR. Why I'm discussing it, because RBI has recently issued an advisory to the banks where it has asked banks to stop using of the LIBOR as a reference rate for different financial contracts or for different loans. Okay, so RBI has issued an advisory to the banks and other regulated entities recently on 8th of July, where RBI has emphasized on the need to stop signing new financial contracts which use LIBOR as the reference rate, as a benchmark. So the advisory was part of a worldwide transition of financial institutions from old benchmarks to new alternative reference rates. It's not just that RBI has advised this for India. Worldwide, different countries are opting for new reference rates and they are shifting from LIBOR to some other alternative reference rate. So, what is LIBOR? I have just discussed that it's the benchmark interest rate at which major global banks lend to one another in the international interbank market for short-term loans. So, kuch banks hote hain, unse pucha jata hai ki aap kis rate pe lend ya borrow karna chahte ho ek dusre se. Uske basis pe kuch rates remove karke, kuch rates ka average nikal ke, finally ek interbank rate banaya jata hai, ek reference rate banaya jata hai, jo LIBOR hai, ye kaise determine hota hai, abhi hum wo aage ki slides mein discuss karenge. So it serves as a globally accepted benchmark interest rate that indicates borrowing cost between banks. So suppose you are taking a loan at a floating rate, say LIBOR plus 2%. So that means that this 2% is fixed, but this will keep on changing. Jaise LIBOR change hoga, waise hi aapka jis rate pe aapko loan mil raha hai, wo change hoga. To aap LIBOR ko as a reference rate leke bahut se loans lete ho, bahut se derivatives hote hain jisme jo investments hai, us wo LIBOR se linked hoti hai. So because of scandals and questions around its validity, it's being phased out. It's the London Interbank Rate. So the UK regulators have decided to phase it out by 30th June 2023 and they will replace this LIBOR with some other alternative rate like Secured Overnight Financing Rate. So this is an alternative to LIBOR which can be used. Okay, so moving ahead to next question, which is again related to LIBOR only. LIBOR is computed for 5 currencies with 7 different maturities ranging from overnight to a year. Which of the following correctly states how LIBOR is determined? So let's first discuss that how we determine LIBOR. सो लाइबोर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड इन फाइव डिफरेंट करेंसीज. लाइबोर को हम स्विस फ्रैंक, यूरो, पाउंड स्टर्लिंग, जापानीज येन, यूएस डॉलर, इन पांच करेंसीज में रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. ओके, पांचों करेंसीज में लाइबोर डिटरमाइन किया जाता है. और ये क्योंकि इंटर बैंक बोरोइंग रेट है, तो एक ओवरनाइट भी हम बोरो कर सकते हैं शॉर्ट टर्म में, या हम एक साल में कभी बोरोइंग ले सकते हैं. सो ओवरनाइट से वन ईयर तक के बीच के अराउंड सेवन डिफरेंट मेच्योरिटीज हैं जिनके लिए लाइबोर डिटरमाइन किया जाता है. सो फाइव डिफरेंट करेंसीज, सेवन टाइप्स ऑफ मेच्योरिटीज, सो अ टोटल ऑफ 35 रेफरेंस रेट्स आर डिटरमाइंड. ठीक है, सो अलग अलग करेंसी का, अलग अलग मेच्योरिटी का एक अलग लाइबोर डिटरमाइन किया जाता है. इट इज कंप्यूटेड फॉर फाइव करेंसीज विद सेवन डिफरेंट मेच्योरिटीज दैट रेंज फ्रॉम ओवरनाइट टू एन ईयर टू अ ईयर. एंड दी फाइव करेंसीज आर द वंस दैट आर मेंशन्ड ओवर हियर, स्विस फ्रैंक, यूरो, पाउंड स्टर्लिंग, जापानीज येन, एंड यूएस डॉलर्स. सो हाउ आर रेट्स डिटरमाइंड? द रेट्स रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द बैंक्स आर अरेंज्ड इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर फर्स्ट, एंड देन from that descending order arranged rates, the top and the bottom quartiles, that is top 25% and the bottom 25% percent are excluded, and whatever rates remain, the average of that, the arithmetic mean of that gives us the LIBOR. So kuch banks hote hain jinse aap reference rate mangte ho, theek hai, to unhone apne apne sabne reference rate unse aap rate mangte ho ki jis pe aap लैंड या बोरो करोगे. सो वो आपको अलग अलग रेट्स देते हैं. ओके, सपोज 20 रेट्स आए आपके पास, आउट ऑफ दोज फर्स्ट यू विल अरेंज देम इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. जो सबसे बड़ा है वो, जो सबसे ज़्यादा रेट है वो सबसे पहले, एंड देन दी लोअर वंस. सो आपने डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर में बड़े से छोटा आपने उन्हें अरेंज कर दिया. अब इसमें से जो टॉप 25% है और जो बॉटम के 25% है, यू रिमूव देम, यू एक्सक्लूड देम, और जो बाकी के बचे उनमें से उनकी आप एवरेज निकालते हो, उनका अरिथमेटिक मीन निकालते हो, एंड दैट गिव्स यू दी लाइबोर. दिस इज हाउ लाइबोर इज कैलकुलेटेड. द प्रोसेस इज रिपीटेड फॉर ईच ऑफ द फाइव करेंसीज एंड द सेवन मेच्योरिटीज, सो वी गेट 35 रेफरेंस रेट्स. दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज टेलिंग यू. सो इफ यू मूव बैक टू आवर क्वेश्चन, द आंसर टू दिस इज ऑप्शन ए, दैट द अरिथमेटिक मीन ऑफ रिमेनिंग डेटा आफ्टर एक्सक्लूडिंग टॉप एंड बॉटम क्वार्टाइल्स फ्रॉम द रेट्स रिसीव्ड arranged in descending order gives us the LIBOR rate. Okay, this is how we calculate LIBOR from all the rates which come up after arranging them in descending order. Top 25%, bottom 25% are excluded, and out of the remaining ones you find the arithmetic mean, the average, and you get, what you get is the reference rate which you calculate for five different currencies for debt, seven different maturities. So this is LIBOR. All right, now let's move on to next very thing which we have to discuss. When will LIBOR cease to exist? So not only India but countries worldwide are thinking to replace LIBOR. So the regulator of the UK regulator FCA is thinking to basically cease LIBOR from 31st December 2021 for your LIBOR which is denominated in pound sterling, euro, Swiss franc, Japanese yen, and ones which are denominated in dollars. If they are 1 week or 2 month LIBOR reference rates, then for them they have to be seized by 31st December of this year. But अदर यू एस डॉलर सेटिंग्स, जो बाकी मेच्योरिटी के लाइबोर रेफरेंस रेट्स है जो यू एस डॉलर्स में डिनोमिनेटेड है, उनको 30th June 2023 तक फेज आउट करना है. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द रेफरेंस रेट्स विल बी फेज आउट रिलेटेड टू विच यूज लाइबोर विल बी फेज आउट बाई 31st December 2021 विथ सम एक्सेप्शन फॉर यू एस डॉलर सेटिंग्स विच विल बी अलाउड टिल June 30, 2023. So the FCA, which is being talked about, is the regulator for financial firms and financial markets in UK. Okay, so what is RBI response on LIBOR transition? RBI in August 2020, last year, advised the banks, the financial institutions, that they should assess their LIBOR exposures and they should go for cessation of LIBOR, that is give an end to LIBOR, shift from LIBOR. And they were also asked to frame a board-approved plan for the steps they will take to address the risks associated with the transition. So 2020 में आरबीआई ने बैंक्स को, फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस को एडवाइस किया था कि आपके जो भी फाइनेंशियल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स हैं, डेरिवेटिव्स हैं, लोन्स हैं जो लाइबोर से लिंक्ड हैं, आप उनको एक बार चेक करो और उनको ट्रांजिशन, यू हैव टू गो फॉर अ ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम लाइबोर टू सम अदर रेफरेंस रेट. सो कैसे शिफ्ट करना है, एक प्रॉपर प्लान बनाओ, चॉक आउट अ प्लान एंड मेक श्योर दैट वट एवर रिस्क आर अराइजिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन दे प्रॉपरली गेट रिड्रेस्ड. सो कैसे आपको क्या क्या करना है ट्रांजेक्शन के लिए, एक प्लान चॉक आउट करने को कहा था आरबीआई ने. And the regulator has now issued a fresh advisory to the banks to prepare for the transition. अब फिर से advisory issue की है RBI ने. लो, let's see what's that advisory. So as per the latest notification of RBI, it has asked the banks and financial institutions to cease entering into new financial contracts which use LIBOR as the benchmark and instead use any widely accepted alternative reference rate as soon as practicable, in any case by 31st December 2021. So, अब RBI ने कहा है banks और financial institutions को कि आपको जो भी नए contracts, financial contracts होंगे, उनमें LIBOR नहीं use करना, कोई और alternative rate use करो, और ये चीज़ आपको 31st December of this year तक करनी है, कि cease using LIBOR and start with some other reference rate. Banks have also been advised to cease using MIFOR. Banks or financial institutions, banks ko ye bhi kaha gaya ke hai ab MIFOR bhi nahi use karo. What is MIFOR? MIFOR stands for the Mumbai Interbank Forward Offer Rate. So ye India mein use kiya jane wala ek benchmark rate hai. It's the rate that Indian banks use as a benchmark for setting prices on forward rate agreements and derivatives. जो forward rate agreements होते हैं, derivatives होते हैं, उसमें ये reference rate के तौर पे use किया जाता है. और ये जो है ना, ये London interbank rate को भी use करता है as a reference. So this Mumbai interbank forward offer rate is a mix of London interbank offer rate and to that some forward premium is added. This way your Mumbai interbank offer rate is determined. So RBI is, क्योंकि ये London interbank rate को use करता है, तो RBI ने कहा है कि इसको भी seize किया जाए, इसको भी as a benchmark rate ना use किया जाए, okay, by 31st December. But the financial benchmarks Indian Private Limited, FBIL, FBIL एक body है, एक independent benchmark administrator है जो RBI approved है. So financial benchmark का FBIL जो है, it has started publishing adjusted MIFOR rates from June 15, 2021 and modified the MIFOR rates which can be used for legacy contracts and fresh contracts. So, pehle ye jo hai MIFOR, ye LIBOR ka use karta tha. Ab kya hai, FBIL ne new adjusted rates nikalne shuru kiye hai MIFOR ke, jo aap naye contracts mein use kar sakte ho, aur jo existing MIFOR hai, jo LIBOR ka use karta hai, usko, usse ab aapko switch bhi karna hai. So, this is what RBI has said. So next question is, identify the rate been talked about over here. So let us see this. It's the rate that Indian banks use as a benchmark for setting prices on forward rate agreements and derivatives, and it's a mix of London interbank offer rate and a forward premium derived from Indian forex markets. This is what we just discussed, MIFOR. So answer is option C. Moving ahead, which will be the new benchmark rate? क्या नया benchmark rate जो हमें LIBOR को replace करके use करना है वो बताया गया है? Mandatorily कोई rate हमें specify नहीं किया गया कि आपने यही use करना है, ठीक है? लेकिन क्या expected rate है? Let's have a look at that. There is no final consensus on what will be the new alternative reference rate. But widely accepted rate, secured overnight financing rate will be accepted as the new benchmark rate. So India में भी हमें यही expected है कि हम LIBOR से shift होके SOFR opt करेंगे. इसके अलावा भी और rates हैं, like we have Sterling Overnight Interbank Average Rate known as SONIA. Okay, so और भी reference rates हैं, most probably we will shift to SOFR. Okay, but it's not mandatory to shift to that only. Now why is the LIBOR transition important? LIBOR scandal हुआ था 2012 में जो सामने आया था, जिसमें ये पता चला था कि LIBOR manipulate किया जा रहा है, जो अभी मैं discuss करूँगी. उसकी वजह से हमें यहाँ से transition करना है. Because of LIBOR scandal, it came into light in 2012. We saw that LIBOR is being manipulated, so the transition is important. Okay, transition is important to manage the potential customer protection. Customer protection के लिए important है. Reputational और litigation risks manage करने के लिए important है. So LIBOR was manipulated. When you are manipulating something, obviously it will attract fines, punishments. So in order to make sure that you don't have to face that litigation, harm your reputation, it's better you shift. It will help avoid the disruptions to the safety and resilience of the financial institutions, and it will ensure the financial stability of the economy. So LIBOR is linked. If London is setting up a LIBOR rate, it's not just that only UK market will be affected. India is using LIBOR for lending different loans, education loans, student loans. Then there are different derivative instruments which are linked to LIBOR. So if LIBOR is being manipulated, then the effects will come to all these things as well. Agar LIBOR jaan ki zyada kiya ja raha hai to student loans diye rahe hain to usme rate badh jayenge. So har cheez pe uska effect aayega. So if you are manipulating LIBOR, then your financial stability will be hampered because it is being manipulated, which can have a devastating impact on the entire economy and the world economies as well. So we need to transition from LIBOR to some other alternative rate. Have Indian banks begin this very shift? Yes. ICICI Bank, State Bank, they have started using SOFR in place of LIBOR. Recently on 9th of July, Axis Bank also used this SOFR in one of its contracts. So they have started shifting from LIBOR to SOFR now. Now talking about this next very question, RBI advised banks and financial institutions to assess their LIBOR exposures that would mature after cessation of LIBOR and frame a board-approved plan for steps to be taken to address this transition. The regulator has now issued a fresh advisory to the banks to prepare for the transition. Which of the following correctly states these advisory directions? So first one is correct ki 31st December tak hume LIBOR se shift karna hai. Third one is also correct ki ye help karega disruptions avoid karne mein aur financial stability ensure karne mein. But the second one is incorrect because it says that RBI has mandated banks to replace LIBOR mandatorily with SOFR. Nahi, SOFR mein shift ho rahe hai banks, but ye mandatory requirement nahi hai. The requirement is just to shift to which rate, that has not been specified. So first and third are correct, that's why answer is option C. So this was all about the questions, but there is one thing which was left to be discussed. Let's discuss that now, which is LIBOR scandal. LIBOR scandal 2012 mein saamne aaya, jahan pata chala ki LIBOR ka rate jo hai usko manipulate kiya ja raha hai. Kabhi usko jaan ke zyada dikhaya jata hai, kabhi usko jaan ke kam dikhaya jata hai. So the LIBOR scandal refers to the major episode of financial collusion in which one of the world's most influential benchmark rates was manipulated by the banks, and this came into light in 2012. The scheme caused financial contracts to be mispriced throughout the world in transactions like mortgages, corporate fundraising, derivatives. So kitne loans the jo LIBOR se linked the, kitne derivatives the, kitne mortgages the, sab LIBOR se linked the. So agar LIBOR manipulate kiya ja raha hai, matlab wo sare hi mispriced hain. The scandal left several regulatory changes, lawsuits, fines in the wakes of damaging public trust. So काफी lawsuits हुए, बड़े बड़े banks थे जो इसमें involved थे, तो fine impose किए गए, लोगों का trust financial markets में कम होने लगा. So that was the problem because of LIBOR. So many big banks were involved in this scandal. बहुत बड़े बड़े banks हैं जो इसमें involved थे, जैसे कि Barclays, Citigroup, JP Morgan, Royal Bank of Scotland. ऐसे बड़े बड़े banks जो हैं ये इस fraud में involved थे, इस scandal में involved थे. Now let's see how this LIBOR was manipulated, or why, how we can say that it was manipulated. During the LIBOR scandal, traders at many of these banks deliberately submitted artificially low or high interest rates to force LIBOR higher or lower. जान के artificially low या high interest rates वो देते थे, जिसे bank से पूछा जाता है ना कि आप किस reference किस rate पे borrow करना चाहते हो, तो वो banks वो rate provide करते हैं, then उनका 25% top bottom से हटा के बाकी का average निकाला जाता है. तो वो जान के कम या ज़्यादा rates देते थे जो उनके favour में हो. The benchmark rates were rigged. If the bank is a net borrower, it artificially deflated the interest rate, and if it's a net lender, then the way around. So kya hota tha, suppose 20 banks are there, okay, and they have to submit the rates, and 15 out of them are borrowers and 5 are lenders, okay. So these 15 banks, they formed informal cartels. They came up together through discussions, through mails, calls. They decided that we will submit this much rate so that we can borrow at low rates. सो जिन्होंने बोरो करना है अगर, तो वो बैंक्स इनफॉर्मली कार्टल बना लेते थे, ग्रुप बना लेते थे, आपस में डिस्कशन करके डिसाइड कर लेते थे कि हम इतना रेट सबमिट करेंगे, तो वो लो रेट सबमिट करते थे जिससे कि एवरेज जो लाइबोर रेट बन के आता था वो लो होता था, तो उन्हें लो रेट्स पे बोरोइंग मिल जाती थी। वही अगर बैंक्स को लेंड करना है, मेजर बैंक्स लेंडिंग बैंक्स है, वो कार्टल बना लेते थे और जान के वो हायर रेट सबमिट करते थे ताकि वो जब लेंड करे तो उन्हें ज्यादा रेट्स मिल सके। ऐसे वो लोग लाइबोर को मैनिपुलेट कर रहे थे। ओके, बैंक्स अंडरस्टेटेड द रेट्स एट विच दे क्लेम दे वुड बोरो इन एन एफर्ट टू मेक देमसेल्व्स लुक फाइनेंशियली स्ट्रॉन्गर। अब बैंक्स को बोरो करना है, वो जान के कम रेट दिखाते थे, अगर कम रेट पे आप बोरो करोगे तो आपके पास आपको कम रेट पे इजिली फंडिंग अवेलेबल मिल जाएगी, आपके पास आप ज्यादा उस उतने ही रेट पे आप ज्यादा पैसा उठा सकते हो, अगर रेट हाई होते तो आप कम पैसा बोरो कर सकते थे, इससे आपके पास ज्यादा मनी होगा, यू विल लुक फाइनेंशियली स्ट्रॉन्गर, जिस वजह से वो लो रेट्स दिखा रहे थे बैंक्स। बैंक शोड लो रेट्स इन ऑर्डर टू बूस्ट देयर प्रॉफिट्स एंड शो अ बेटर रेपुटेशनल पोजिशन। सो वी कैन बोरो एट लेस रेट, यूज देम टू जनरेट प्रॉफिट्स विच विल शो बेटर रेपुटेशनल पोजिशन, जिस वजह से वो लो रेट दिखाते थे। सो लाइबोर डेंट सीम टू रिफ्लेक्ट करेंट मार्केट कंडीशंस। बाकी इंटरेस्ट रेट्स मूव करते थे, उनके हिसाब से लाइबोर सेम पेस पे मूव नहीं करता था क्योंकि वो मैनिपुलेट किया जा रहा था, तो जो करंट मार्केट कंडीशंस है वो उसको पोर्ट्रे नहीं करता था। लाइबोर डेंट सीम टू रिफ्लेक्ट करंट मार्केट कंडीशंस, अ मेजॉरिटी ऑफ लाइबोर सबमिशंस वर अनचेंज्ड फ्रॉम डे टू डे इवन दो अदर इंटरेस्ट रेट्स वर फ्लक्चुएटिंग। सो पार्टिसिपेटिंग बैंक्स मैनिपुलेटेड लाइबोर टू एनहांस देयर प्रॉफिट्स and they formed the cartels to and decide and go for higher or lower submissions deliberately. Okay, so they deliberately moved the average up and down as per their needs. So this was the LIBOR scandal. Now, how LIBOR affected world economies? It's not just that the impact of LIBOR was just restricted to UK, but its effects were seen worldwide because the mortgages, the student loans, the financial derivatives and different other financial products relied on LIBOR as a reference rate. The manipulation of submissions used to calculate those rates can have a negative effect on all these consumer and financial markets worldwide. So, agar LIBOR jaan ke zyada dikhaya ja raha hai aur LIBOR se hi linked hai student loan, to ye loan ka bhi interest rate badh jayega. So, mispricing ki wajah se ek student ko loan pe zyada paisa dena padega. So this way, if LIBOR is manipulated, other things will be mispriced and thus affected. That's why there is a need to shift from LIBOR. So this was all about what is LIBOR, what are different alternative rates available, why RBI has decided to transition, not only RBI, why world economies are transitioning from LIBOR to other rates, what rate is being preferred by other countries as an alternative to LIBOR, and what was the LIBOR scandal. Okay, so this was all for today's session. I hope the session was useful for you. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.